Welcome to my engineering drawing playlist. Today I will be explaining cycloid. In the previous video we have discussed about the classification of the engineering curves, and so far we have discussed the different methods for the ellipse, parabola and hyperbola. Now it's turn for the next group of the engineering curve, that is the cycloidal. So let's start with the first one from the cycloidal group, is the cycloid. So before starting the cycloid, first let's see the concept of cycloid, epicycloid and hypocycloid. So here you can see this red color is actually called as cycloid. So very simple, when the rolling circle rolls on the straight line, then the point which is on the circumference of the rolling circle makes the path, that is called as the cycloid. Now here you can see the next one is the epicycloid. So can you differentiate, my dear friends, what is the difference between cycloid and epicycloid from this figure? Yes, absolutely, very simple. If the rolling circle rolls on the another circle, then it's called as the epicycloid. Here, the rolling circle rolls on the straight line. That's why it is the cycloid. Now next, hypocycloid. Here, the rolling circle rolls inside of the circle. Then it will generate the hypocycloid. So very simple concept of cycloid, epicycloid and hypocycloid. So once again, if the rolling circle rolls on the straight line, then it will create cycloid. If the rolling circle rolls outside of the circle, then it is called as epicycloid. If the rolling circle rolls inside of the circle, then it will generate the hypocycloid. Now let's start with the cycloid. So let's see first of all the definition of cycloid. It is a locus of a point, here you can see on the circumference of the rolling circle, that is sometimes known as the generator, which rolls without slipping or sliding along a fixed straight line. Sometimes it is called as the directing line or a director. So very simple definition. Now let's see the problem description. A circle of 40 mm diameter rolls along a straight line without slipping. Draw the curve traced out by a point which is on the circumference of the circle for one complete revolution. Give the name of the curve. Draw tangent and normal to the curve at a point 35 mm above the directing line. So here you look at the description. A circle of 40 mm diameter rolls along a straight line. So definitely you can say the output will be the cycloid. So your second answer is the cycloid. Name of the curve is cycloid. So now let's see how can we solve this problem step by step. So here we are going to draw this shape, that is actually cycloid. Here rolling circle rolls on the straight line, and here you can see this is actually the point on the circumference of the rolling circle, and the path of this point is known as cycloid, and we are going to draw the cycloid for one revolution only, that means from here to here. Now first try to understand the description. So here this is the directing line. Here you can see in this figure, this one is the directing line on which the rolling circle rolls. So this is actually the reference line on which this is the rolling circle, and this is the point on the circumference of the circle, and we are going to draw the path of this circle for one complete revolution of this rolling circle on this directing line. Here keep in mind that we have assumed initially this point is actually the contact point of this rolling circle with directing line. You can assume anywhere initially the point P on the circumference of the circle. I have assumed over here. Now focus on this point only. So this is actually the locus of this point, and that will create the path that is known as the cycloid. So this is very simple concept. So I think now you are very much clear about the terminology. Directing line, that is a fixed straight line on which the rolling circle rolls. And here the diameter is given to you for this rolling circle as 40 mm diameter. Now let's see how you can draw this curve step by step. So first of all, draw the circle with 40 mm diameter. So take a compass, set the radius as 20 mm because of this is diameter. So 20 mm is the radius. Now draw the circle. This is actually a rolling circle. Now give the dimension. Now this is the reference horizontal line that is called as the directing line. Initially, take the length randomly of this horizontal line. Now divide this circle into the 12 equal parts. And you know that how you can divide the circle into the 12 equal parts. If you don't know, then refer my earlier video of the same topic, means how to divide the circle into the 12 equal parts. Now give the name as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Here I have given the number from this point because of I have assumed initially the point is over here on the circumference of the circle. And if the rolling circle rolls clockwise direction, then this point will touch with the directing line. That's why it is 1, 2, 3, 4 in this direction. So actually rolling circle rolls in the clockwise direction, and so that the numbering is in the anticlockwise direction. Now you have to find the total distance that is covered by the rolling circle for one complete revolution. And that you know very well, circumference of the circle, that is equal to pi d. And here the diameter of the rolling circle is given to you as 40 mm. So if you multiply pi with the 40 mm, so you will get 125.6 mm. So mark one point that is 125.6 mm away from this point. So here you can see 125 and 125.6, so almost you can say it is 126. So this is actually the end position of the rolling circle after one complete revolution. So mention it. 125.6 mm. This is the end position of the circle. Now draw the center line up to here. Now divide this distance into the 12 equal parts. And definitely it is a little bit difficult to divide this distance, that means 125.6 mm into the 12 equal parts with the help of the scale. So at that time, you can draw one inclined line, which is having the length 120 mm, and so that you can divide it. And if you don't know this method, then definitely you can refer my earlier video that how to divide the line into the 12 equal parts. Now draw the vertical line from these all points up to the center line so that you will get the intersection point. Give the name as C0, C1, C2, C3, C4 up to C12. This is the center line, that's why I have given C0, C1 up to C12 number. Now next, draw the horizontal line passing through all these points on the circumference of the circle up to here. As we have discussed, initially we are going to assume the point on the circumference of the circle is here. That's why it is P0. Now next step is a very important step. Set the radius, that is exactly equal to the radius of the rolling circle. Here you can see the diameter of the rolling circle is 40 mm and so that the radius is 20 mm. Now take C1 as the center Now listen it carefully. Draw the arc on the horizontal line which is passing through the point 1. Because of here you have taken C1 as the center. So here you can see this is the arc on the horizontal line passing through the point 1. Now mark the point over here. This is P1. So here keep in mind that you can definitely assume that if the rolling circle rolls in this direction, then it will be rise over here. So definitely you can assume that the P1 point is here, not here. Now next, you have to repeat the same step with the same radius. Now your center is C2. So the same radius, take C2 as the center, draw the arc on the horizontal line passing through the point 2, that means on this line. So you will get the intersection point over here, mark it as P2. Now next, with the same radius, C3 as the center, draw the arc on the line which is passing through the point 3, that means on the center line. Draw the arc and so that you will get the intersection point, mark it as P3. Similarly, you can find P4. At that time, C4 is your center. Now draw the arc with C5 as the center. So you will get P5. Now C6 as the center, so that you will get P6. Here also you will get P6 easily by extending this vertical line. So don't waste the time to draw this circle. Simply extend this line. So you will get P6 here. You have to repeat the same step. Now C7 is the center. Draw the arc so that you will get P7, P8, P9, P10, P11 and at last P12. Now join all the points by the smooth curve. So you will get cycloid. So it is really very simple. So far we have completed the first task. Draw the curve, trace out by a point, which is actually P point over here, on the circumference of the circle or one complete revolution. Now second task, give the name of the curve. You know that here rolling circle rolls on the straight line, so that definitely it will be cycloid. So this is your second answer. Now third one. Draw tangent and normal to the curve at a point 35 mm above the directing line. So you know that this is a directing line and 35 mm above the directing line. So here I am going to take 35 mm distance. So here this is a line which is 35 mm from the directing line. So this line cut the cycloid at these two different points. So you can draw the normal and tangent at any point out of these two points. So let's say I am going to draw the tangent and normal at this point. Give the name as V, where I am going to draw the normal and tangent. Now set the compass as 20 mm radius. This is actually the radius of the rolling circle. Now take V as the center, draw the arc on the center line. Keep in mind that. So it will cut the center line here. Mark it as Q point. Now join VQ. Next, draw the vertical line passing through this Q point, which will intersect to the directing line at this point. Give the name as N. Join NV. That is your normal. And perpendicular to normal, passing through the point V will give you as a tangent. And that definitely you can do with the help of the scale. Match the long line on the scale to this normal. So automatically it will give you the perpendicular line. That is the tangent. So this is your third answer. Draw normal and tangent to the curve at a point 35 mm above the directing line. So definitely you can draw the normal and tangent at this point also. But keep in mind that in the examination, cycloid, normal and tangent should be only dark. The rest of the part must be as light as possible. So once again, look at the concept of the cycloid. So it is really very interesting. So look at carefully. This is a rolling circle, rolls, and so that it will generate the cycloid. So this is actually the concept. So this concept will be very useful for the concept of epicycloid and hypocycloid that we are going to see in the next video. At last, what will be the effect if I divide the circle into the 8 equal parts instead of these 12 equal parts? Write your answer in the comment box. Thanks my dear friends for watching this video. Press the like button to appreciate.